We're going to be playing the play-in in NBA 2K. So it's going to be the Hawks versus the Heat and the Lakers versus the Timberwolves. Let's get into it. The first game will be, let's go Lakers versus Timberwolves. So, whichever one I see first, I'm going to be. Alright, so I'm gonna be the Lakers. Alright, so now we gotta get the. Alright, let's get into the game.
Today we have last year's 2K TV Awards winner for the WMVP.
I wish you could
George
skip by these, it would be so much
us.
Better.
How are you doing?
It'd be like really, really.
We're gonna hop into the W to play
the
a game with our
NBA
very own Chris Manning and Brian Bamifatemi.
George, you were the MVP last year, taking home that 2K TV award.
I'm just really thankful for 2K TV giving me
the
opportunity.
Question,
and you know what? I have to ask, what do you like about 2K23's W?
Unless you're in the WNBA or associated.
Coming right up.
Hi. We're in the game now. LeBron,
welcome everyone. Thanks for tuning in to 2K. Payday.
Thanks very much.
Not at all. Yeah, some similarities definitely there, David. Thank you. And now the Lakers starting group. We've got Jared Vanderbilt. He's out there with Davis. Russell is out there with LeBron James.
I am going to be playing the Lakers
and from Minnesota.
Heat and the Hawks in this
fighting
video
in at the wing, it'll be Edwards and McDaniel.
Reeves,
two big men inside.
Reeves.
Towns and Gobert.
Conley.
And it's Conley in at the point guard.
Get
now, every season
here.
We hear mention of the rookie wall. Is
LeBron.
That real, Steve, or is it just a myth?
Kevin, it's real.
Anyway.
For some players, the NBA seems so much longer and more grueling than the college season. It's certainly an exhausting adjustment.
LeBron.
Now, here's McDaniel. After LeBron James's miss, they get it again. Edwards kicks to McDaniel. Tries again. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
Here comes AD.
Davis
LeBron.
Looking for an opening. Jacks up a three.
For three.
A nice bang!
Shot by
LeBron.
LBJ for
LeBron's
three.
LeBron's got the first 3 points of the night up on the board.
That's
Los
a
Angeles.
Green bean, too.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
LeBron
the pass to Edwards.
Comment down below who you think better, LeBron
with the rebound.
Or MJ. I think it's MJ.
Four here, still looking for the first man.
Dunk on him. And
one. Foul on the shot. He'll shoot.
He went for the dunk, but he got fouled by Cat.
Well, we know we're in the later stages of his career, but Steve, it's just simply incredible, mind-boggling, really, how athletic LeBron James remains.
What the
Kevin,
heck?
To put it frankly,
his jump shot
we've
is
never
like
seen
weird.
Anything like this. He's still getting up with ease for some vicious throwdowns.
Right.
A testament to how hard he works.
Oh, he missed.
And really, is there anything LeBron can't do? One of the most versatile players the game has ever seen.
Outside.
D-Lo. Oh my God.
Off target
I'm
with this
terrible
three.
At shooting.
And
I haven't played in a minute.
Thought that triple was gonna fall.
Nick Daniels up top. Vanderbilt defending.
Gobert
the pass to Edwards. From deep.
Ant-Man. Nope.
Headshot off. And it's the Lakers the other way.
LeBron James.
They put up a nice win against
going
Utah
down.
Last time out.
Dunk it.
I like their aggressiveness in that one. No one's going to give you anything. You've got to go out and take it. Majority of the night, they were in attack mode. Tremendous effort all the way around.
I'm just trying to score with LeBron.
To get this game started. So the Lakers
why did
timeout.
It?
They're first.
Yeah,
with the struggles AD has had to stay healthy.
He literally scored.
And you wonder,
I heard
though, if the
team's
going to focus on having him be at his best for that postseason and try to manage the wear and tear.
LeBron.
Here's James.
Step
boy,
back.
He was something else against Utah. From deep three-point range. It's rebounded by
terrible.
And they're
trying
to start this game. Just really having
LeBron can't
into
shoot.
A flow offensively.
A pass to McDaniels.
McDaniels.
And at the top of the key, Towns. Towns is doubled.
Get that out of here.
Outside Conley. Five on the clock.
No. Oh, my God.
Good, and the assist goes to town. And when Davis is on the floor, Greg, he is a force. But how do you keep him healthy into the playoffs? That is the question.
I mean, sustaining his output over a full season isn't easy, but Davis has had...
Oh, he's open for three. That's a green.
So you have to mitigate ways to keep him available. And that pick takes the D totally out of the equation.
Hey, if you're not going to fight over, you're essentially giving the shooter the look he wants.
And it's out of bounds. Whoa, what? Touched by Russell.
Oh, my God.
And a chance now to take a look at some numbers for LeBron James.
What is he doing? Nobody cares about this. One. Oh, get that out of here!
Reach makes get that out of defender. Here!
Not
capable
in my house!
Sending shots back from anywhere.
Get out of here! The weak stuff.
From the arc.
It's been a rough quarter for him. Can't seem to
complete
find any kind of rhythm.
Complete the clip.
And Davis gets it to go.
Just setting the tone with an aggressive move to the rack. And where's the help defensively?
No excuse. You have to be aware. He should be on your radar all the time.
And that was the Mobile One drive. Well worth a second look.
It's all about the ability to get 2 feet in the paint, whether it's creating 14.
I want to turn the timeouts off.
A new lineup here for the Timberwolves.
But I don't know how.
Here's Noel. He's guarded by Russell. Rivers dishes to Anderson.
Get that's a block.
A classic NBA question. Right. Who's been the best franchise in league history? Celtics or the Lakers?
Come on, Kevin. You are putting me on the spot.
That's
an
easy question.
I'd go with the Lakers. More superstars over the years. I think that 2000s was with Kobe.
Bro, what do you mean? The Lakers are way better.
You see the physicality of LeBron. Doesn't fear absorbing contact on the way up.
Wow, but what, he have something in his eye on that shot?
I can't shoot free throws, though.
Now here's Rivers. He averages about 5 points a game. Shooting foul.
Wait, what?
As the whistle blows, he'll shoot two free throws.
Never mind.
And the assets traded by the Wolves from
Timberwolves
surprised a lot of people. In essence, five first-round picks, three of them unprotected. They better hope this thing works out. A lot right now.
I'll tell you, he doesn't give points away. Excellent job from the line.
Here's James. And there it is for LeBron's got five.
The indestructible one. LeBron brushing off contact with an easy deuce.
Knocks it loose.
Who's following? I'm going to lob it.
Vanderbilt kicks to LeBron over Prince.
I meant to rebound. I meant to alley-oop him.
Has not brought this team down.
Oh, my God. How are they already on the bonus? I fouled them four times.
This is his first chance at the line tonight.
At 74%, you know, so-so, we probably wouldn't mind seeing it a little bit higher.
We all know Kyle Anderson can do it all. Once he gets a little bit more consistent with the shot,
give me a
watch
pick.
Out.
I'm throwing it up to AD.
Passes it to Reeves.
Bro, what kind of pass even was that? LeBron. LeBron James.
Noel.
Two and one, two. Are you serious?
Go to the line.
Oh my God, bro. When they tie in the game like that, that's so stupid.
Sometimes Rivers gets locked in to find
his own
shot.
For yourself.
This time, finds the open man.
Now here's LeBron. He has five. Pass to Vanderbilt. LeBron dishes to Russell.
Post up.
Takes the 13-footer.
Huh?
And it's Davis.
That's a dream all day. What do you
play
mean?
Call. Even
Shoot
though
that.
He could convert, that's a good shot.
He missed field.
Prince outside.
Come on.
Now the pass to Reed. Turn around, Jim.
No.
It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
Come on, run the floor. Run the floor, LeBron.
James, left side.
Come on. And one! LeBron James!
Tremendous body control. LeBron takes the hit. He takes the shot.
But I can't
Absolutely stone cold at the line thus far.
It's 9 seconds separating the shot.
I want to get a block of LeBron.
Pass to Reed. He feeds it to Rivers.
Dude, how do you miss that?
And you can see the defenders Did I get a buzzer beater?
I think I'm gonna get a buzzer beater with you, though.
But on that one, they were there.
Outside, Russell. For the three.
Buzzer beater.
And that one released in time, but no good. It's the end of one, a closely contested game so far. Lakers.
The Lakers. 12.
That's the end of the first quarter.
Wolves fans, you know them, you love them.
And this has been a fairly close game through the first quarter, and we'll see what happens here in the second.
And what we've seen so far
from the Lakers, guys, what are your thoughts?
I'm not going to
You could see they were well prepared defensively coming into this
one. LeBron from deep.
What they do, they take away the things that teams like to do offensively, also keeping them out of sync.
Taking a look at Los Angeles.
Hey, get that out of here!
It's Russell.
LeBron, get that out of here. And get that out of here. That's an insane block.
Here to see that powerful rejection.
Yeah, quick thinking pays off big. What a block.
Now here's Edwards.
Not a brick.
Getting warmed up offensively.
No. Come on, D-Lo, you need to do something.
For others, Edwards moving it with conviction.
Here is Russell.
Green bean.
They trail by one.
Dude, I can't make a shot. That's a green bean. It's literally on the green
thing. Now, here's McDaniel. And James picks up the foul. That's his first foul. Well, there's one thing, Greg, that defines a modern NBA big man. It is mobility.
And they've got to be able to move their feet and really play in space. Otherwise, they just can't stay on the floor in today's game.
Now, here's Towns. He picked up 30 points in their last win against New Orleans.
I thought that was
it
a block.
It wasn't just the points. He brought
LeBron.
Hustle. He brought
going
energy.
Down.
And he brought
Love it
on the glass.
Hey! AD on his head. Oh, my God. 180. Oh, my God. That was
insane.
Through
the first minute here in the
second. Holy. That was cool.
Passes it to McDaniels.
Nah, that's a brick.
Misses the three.
Not LeBron then. LeBron
so it's
now.
Davis
go to
the
hoop, LeBron.
The ball up for the Los Angeles Lakers. James
wide open.
Open.
Dude, how did I miss that? I'm actually terrible.
To miss one of those once in a
that's
while.
A brick.
Edwards, that's good.
And that was a confident
oh my God,
shot.
Look
when Edwards just rises up and fires off the dribble.
James,
dude,
no good.
I didn't even click the.
And now approaching 2 minutes of action here in the second quarter. Outside, Edwards.
Come on. Come at me.
He kicks it to McDaniels. 6 on the shot clock.
I'm going to block it.
Here's the 3.
No. That's
they
not
grab their own miss.
Dude.
It's good.
Oh, my God.
It's a 3-point Minnesota lead.
I'm actually terrible.
At the scoreboard, you think they were the team trailing and trying to fight their way back.
Davis finds James. Gobert with
he
the
He just
block.
Got blocked.
The wingspan of Gobert is huge. And he uses it so well.
For God's sake, got Gobert.
2 free throws coming up, and they call
dude, that's not a foul. That's a block. That's all ball, bro.
And GA, he is becoming the leader of this Timberwolves team, isn't he?
Partly it's his production with his numbers up across the board, but it's also his personality.
And 1-3.
He plays with tremendous swagger.
Now here's Davis. His last outing, 16.
Dude, I can't shoot with LeBron. He's terrible at shooting.
He's kind of lost his way this period.
God,
he had a hard time getting anything to go down.
Quarters.
He just doesn't look like himself this quarter. Something's missing. And it also shows you how difficult this game is. He's just
what even was
old,
that?
But it can result in missing everything.
That one goes.
Dude.
Oh,
my God.
Up to six now for Minnesota.
Agile move off the contact by Edwards, getting to his shot despite the difficult defense.
Give me a pick.
There's
what? I passed it to LeBron!
Rebounded by the Timberwolves.
God, bro.
In the game.
Yeah, just a solid job on the backboard. They are really controlling the inside.
Oh, get that out of here.
Impeccable timing on the rejection.
Are you serious? Are you serious right now, bro?
You know we talk about it all
the
time.
Dude, are you actually kidding me?
Second chance buckets, always the result of that extra effort.
Now here's James. 7 points in the game.
Come on. Vanderbilt, don't know who you are.
Russell against Conley.
I don't think anybody knows who you are.
The run.
Good take.
And Russell with the lay-in. Russell's
finally
got his first 2 points.
With a gentle touch inside. Russell really improving as a finisher.
And give me that.
Good job to get that angle on a tremendous drive.
His team is down, but with the way he went at the
terrible
run, they'll keep
terrible
the entire game.
Vanderbilt, come on, you can lock up. You can lock up Cat,
apparently.
Bro!
And that'll be two free throws coming up.
Come on, bro! This game is so dumb. What do you mean?
It's all about the fire they're playing with early on.
This is so stupid.
Crashing the boards, and the result, second chance points.
Come on, LeBron.
And they are also just outworking the opposition in transition. When the break is on, they've continued to find ways to score.
Kyle Anderson, who's checked in for the Timberwolves. Noel comes in for Michael
Timberwolves.
And he gets contact.
Can I actually make free throws?
Two shots coming up.
And once LeBron gets the ball in the painted area,
dude,
the force he plays with, it's hard not to foul him.
And he has been grinding away to get himself to the line. It hasn't always turned into points, but he's doing a lot of the dirty work for them.
Reed, he's right, checked in for Minnesota. And let's head
what
over
the
to the sideline and catch up with David Alderman.
Dude,
thanks very much.
Come on! Bro, I'm actually terrible at defense. I just got my ankle scratched by a NPC, bro.
It's not even close. Outside of Bill, we have all the dominant closers. Kobe, Jerry, LeBron now, Irving. Come on now, it's just too many Lakers.
Dude!
Kevin, back to you.
Oh my God, we're down
David.
By
we thank you for
11 points.
Wow,
we need to make a comeback.
Been this quarter, they're riding that hot hand.
Trying to break that ice cold streak. Finished off by LeBron.
Oh my
Very
God.
Athletic move by LeBron on
oh
the slam.
Oh my God, on his head. He just got
posters.
Oh my God.
Pass to Noel.
Oh my God.
LeBron against Anderson.
Oh my.
It's
bro,
good.
He
makes
his
first shot of the game.
Oh my God.
Starting to shake off
bro
the horrible shooting slump they suffered there through the first quarter.
Right side Davis.
Dude.
Back to LeBron. Fires from deep. He can't get that one. And Minnesota will come the other way. They defeated the Pelicans in their last game.
Well, dude, what the heck? We're down by.
It's a lot of fun when you get into
13.
That kind of a groove.
You know, I love what the coaches did tonight. They pushed the right buttons time and time again.
But the game's not even over. What is
it? The Minnesota lead has been cut down to 11 on the bucket from Anthony Davis. For three, Edwards.
I swear to God.
Another
dude,
shot.
Get a rebound, Anthony Davis. You know what?
From Rudy Gobert. Gobert's got six here in this quarter.
Mo Bamba's coming in.
The long reach of Rudy Gobert.
Mo
really
Bamba's
comes in
handy coming in
when he's patrolling the offensive glass.
And a deep three from James, and the last second attempt doesn't fall. And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves.
Are you serious?
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway. It's the 2K
I don't
Sports
care about
halftime time show.
Hey,
shot.
Welcome back. It
Big
is.
Shot.
It was a
Big
closely
shot.
Contested first quarter for Minnesota. They what? Trailed by as many as 6 points in the first period.
Now we're down. We're down by 13, bro.
And that's gonna do.
Are you serious right now, bro? All right, can I get to the game now?
And with the second
all
half upon
come
us,
on.
We'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening
come
to
on.
Be.
I want
to
play.
Like what we're seeing from Anthony Edwards.
All right, Mo Bamba's in. Now that means we're gonna.
We were able to find an answer for him over the break. He was scoring with ease.
I think both sides probably adjusted a few things. The key for him is to bring the same level of energy over these last two quarters.
Two big men inside.
Jump shot is slow.
Hiding in at the wing, it'll be Edwards and McDaniels. And it's Conley in at the one.
That's
Chris Finch's five as we get into the second half.
And now in the final year of his contract, D'Angelo Russell trying to get back to that all-star level and the promise that got him that last four-year deal.
Bro.
Conley, the pass to Towns.
Towns
has got the lead up to 14 now for the Timberwolves. And it's Russell in the corner. And it's
come on,
from Obama. Three-point range.
That's why I put you with to get the rebound.
Performance in last year's playoffs. Russell has some making up to do.
That's what I need. I need the rebound from Mo Bamba.
Mo Bamba. The offensive end. You can't just be a volume score.
And looking at that replay again, just a big time block right there.
And that block might serve as a spark for this team. We'll see if it can ignite them.
Edwards kicks to McDaniel. Conley surveying the D. Over in the corner, Edwards.
Quick.
And the three off target.
Just not feeling it from beyond the arc. Sometimes that happens. He's trying to shoot his way out of it.
Bamba's
dude,
shot is
no
off.
Bamba, you're
and
crap.
The pressure he put on that shot forced the miscue.
The rim protection at its finest. The result is the same whether you block the shot or simply change it.
LeBron James on the wing. Daniels defending.
And they start the second half.
Who sure was that?
Misses.
Here's Edwards.
There's actually no. There is no way that just went
in. The game.
And don't let Edwards' position fool you. Anthony is built like a linebacker. That upper body strength helps him down low.
And there was another look at the fantastic.
Oh my God.
Still going hard. And that kind of energy and effort is how they built this team.
Prince has checked in for the Timberwolves. Rivers comes in for Edwards. Conley finds McDaniel.
I need to let him shoot.
Launches it. Rebound the Lakers.
And you don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
LeBron outside. Outside, Russell fires for three. And Carl Anthony Towns pulls it down.
God.
Towns has got rebound number 7 for him tonight. Here's McDaniels, and he banks in the lane. McDaniels got his second basket.
Another good play. This is how they built the lead, calling on the right guys.
I don't even care at this point.
The reason why they stayed aggressive,
LeBron,
and they have not let up this entire night. And at this point, I wouldn't expect them to.
LeBron passes to Reeves.
Oh, yeah, Mo Bamba.
Here's Bamba. Another miss, and they desperately need a bucket.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards.
Where's AD?
The pass to come. Back to McDaniel. Outside Conley. And that's an intentional foul.
Bro.
Yeah, not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a great cramp.
Minnesota
I forgot you can't call timeouts on defense.
Kyle Anderson in for McDaniel.
Oh,
Davis has checked in for Los Angeles. Timeout called the Lakers.
The wheels have come off a little bit leading up to this timeout. He has taken some low percentage shots, and it's killing
bro,
the floor
what
of their offense.
I can't see the
more
game
motion,
they're playing right
more
now.
Ball movement, that should lead to better looks for him and for the entire team.
Down 18.
Prince against James.
About to be down 20.
And that one
yep, I called it.
The whistle and two shots
down by 20.
Certain things make Prince a tough cover. Strength, long arms, quickness that can surprise you.
Noel, he's checked in for Minnesota. And both free throws good for Prince. Well, we know confidence is key. But, Steve, when you see young players who haven't done much in the playoffs acting like they've arrived,
Can that
and long.
Hold them back a little bit?
Well, you love confidence in anything you do, Kevin. Obviously, you need it. But it can backfire. You love that guys want to say they're great, but it all
down
comes
by
down
17.
To proving it.
Allen for Anthony Davis, a big contributor to this team when healthy.
Kevin, AD does everything on the court that you ask of him. He can defend his space and guard just about anybody. Along with being a force on the offensive side, he's a terrific talent.
Timberwolves leading by 15. Pass to Noel. It's Rivers on the wing. To the middle. Here's Anderson.
One.
Vanderbilt with the rebound. Vanderbilt's got four rebounds in this game. James with it. Guarded now by Prince. Here's Davis. Back to James. And they double up LeBron. Passes it to Reeves.
2 minutes remaining in the third. 2 minutes.
Los Angeles needs to get off a shot here. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
He's been of no help stretching the floor tonight. Just 1-3 in the first
Come
half.
On, bro.
Nothing in the second. And all second half, they haven't gotten stops with any consistency.
Over to the wing. Loads it up for Davis.
Dude.
And out of bounds is the Timberwolves.
Oh, my God. You can't catch
Boy,
a wall.
You hate to see that kind of miscommunication between your guys.
Minnesota making some changes. Anthony
Towns. Oh, my God. It just did that on purpose. I didn't even go that way. It just gripped me back.
For Noel.
And now I'm back. And now I got called for a back play. Like, seriously?
Here's Reed.
Oh, my God, bro.
And the Timberwolves lead by 19.
The playmaking ability of Kyle Anderson combines great floor vision with his height and feel.
Russell looking around.
And one.
And the call on the shot. It sends him to the line.
Even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for Minnesota.
Like
High effort, fast
skills.
Break plays.
Like
they have been
game.
Very effective for them in this game, generating a lot of points for them.
And just a great job converting those second chances as well. They're having a great night getting those second and third shot.
All right.
The Timberwolves have shot 10 of 13 from the free throw line.
And on the season, you know, they're hitting about 76%, which is a decent rate. Just a solid contributor. Mike Conley has continued to age, and he looks.
He just got blocked.
Yeah, he's terrific, especially at setting the pace and orchestrating an offense. Also solid at realizing how to get his teammates involved. A selfless distributor who looks to make his guys better.
Why would you take a layup
they keep
from the
his
right
number,
wing?
Which is partly how they've dug this
the
hole.
The right elbow.
Towns dishes to Conley. To Anderson beyond the arc.
Dude.
Oh, and he almost had a 4-point play right there. He'll go to the line with a chance for three.
Fifth personal foul. Team is
not explosive at all. Kyle Anderson is crafty. Nice play to draw the foul.
This is his second trip to the free throw line. Free throw, good, Anderson. Good on the second free throw.
About 85% from the line. That's up from where it was in that first half.
Rudy Gobert, he's checked in for Nas Reed. The Lakers
Aye!
Also with a shot.
80 is only 80.
He moves so well for a guy his size. When AD attacks, good luck stopping him.
Gotta run the clock and wait for the last shot.
Yes, you do, but it's a dilemma. If you get a great look earlier
Dude,
in the clock, you take it.
Balls out.
Second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
Hey, another dunk.
By Davis.
Back in the day, big man would carry your offense. Times have changed, but 80s, one, he can still do it.
And D'Angelo Russell picks up the foul. That will get him his fourth foul of the game. And the bonus will head to the line for two. He'll take his third and fourth free throw shots in the game right here.
And taking a look back at his performance at the line a year ago, rock solid 79%.
It's stolen by Gobert.
I swear to freaking God.
Alley-oop
try. Get that out of here.
And they'll keep possession.
I swear.
And so it's Minnesota controlling the game and finishing the quarter with a 20-point lead. Their defensive mindset clearly focused.
33.
How about a look at today's State Farm assist to the game?
And he sliced the D wide open with his feet. They had no chance to prevent that basket.
Creating plays for others, it's an art form, but it's also a discipline. Fantastic job.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. And on the court for the Lakers to start the fourth. Jared Vanderbilt out there with Anthony Davis.
We can't make a comeback.
And it's Reeves in at the two guard.
And we are seeing tonight why Edwards was selected first overall. Anthony has a special ability to score.
Davis kicks to Russell. Let's it go with a three. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. There?
And when you can't get anything to fall, it definitely gets in your head.
And his rhythm, it's been way off. The goal now might be to get him something easy at the rim so he could just see the ball go in through the net, and that helps.
Here's Russell with a three.
See, that was literally a perfect
shot. Edwards got seven rebounds in the game. Conley with the three. Here's Towns.
Why
the jump ball.
Second chance points. There's really been an issue here defensively.
I'm glad we got a chance to check out that fantastic drive one more time. Gobert with the ball.
Oh, my God, this is so freaking long.
And we've seen not only some new trophies, but some of the existing ones have been updated. You okay with that?
Oh, I am. In particular, a nice touch to have the previous winners etched into the base of the Larry O'Brien Trophy. That's a great way to connect with the history of the game.
And Russell gets it to go.
Three.
Good form on the jump shot. Russell's ability to stretch the floor makes him even more valuable.
I swear.
That's not a foul. That's on D'Angelo Russell.
For years, Mike Conley had an interesting time. The best player to never make an all-star game. Well, that changed in 2021 when Conley was named an all-star.
Looking at who's out there now for the Timberwolves. Reed, he's checked in for Carl Anthony Towns. Torian Prince comes in for McDaniels. And it's Rivers in for Edwards. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. James has checked in. Russell, no luck for Mike Conley. Year 13 was lucky for him, going to that first all-star game.
And that was the longest wait ever to become an all-star. Conley, 33 at the time of that first selection, just shows you the work ethic of Mike.
That's not a book when you're a bench player.
And offensively, they seem to have turned a corner.
James outside, and the pass to Vanderbilt. Stolen by Reed. Conley against Vanderbilt. And it's Conley penetrating. Reed kicks to Gobert. And there's the whistle. 3-second violation. We talk about players. We talk about coaches and GMs. But not too much about owners and their effect on the game and the organization.
Kevin, the owners for me are A1. It starts from the top. They're the ones who fire the team president, GMs, and coaches. And certainly, there are some teams who have some great owners.
No good. Shot missing. Nice D from Russell. Los Angeles has gotten some tough luck from three-point range. In the fourth quarter, they've hit just 1 of 6 from deep. LeBron James on the wing.
The wing jumper off target.
At some point, when you recognize someone's this out of rhythm, you have to shift to something else.
And he's been a force on the glass all game long.
He has led this team in rebounding and also taken on the role of enforcers.
First team foul.
And the first one at the line is good.
Shooting for Los Angeles.
Minnesota making some changes. Morris checked in for Reed. And Nikhil Alexander-Walker in for Rivers. The Timberwolves have gone 4 of 8 in this fourth quarter, shooting an even 50% from the field. James against Moore.
Gobert down low. And
And
he's now got the double-double. 10 points and 13 rebounds.
It doesn't get any easier than that for Rudy Gobert. His size is sometimes overpowering.
From the arc, Reeves gets the bucket.
This is why you're trying to get him as many touches as possible. He's got the neck.
Minnesota leading by 23. Noel passes to Gobert. And player nicknames are a fun part of covering the game. Now a lot of guys, GA, are just going with their initials, like KD or AD or KG. Do we need more creativity?
I don't know, Kevin. Maybe the league could give guys a cash bonus for picking a nickname. Initials excluded. That might spark some creativity.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Timberwolves.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought, an all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that. And man, they just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And so when you look at the season record, this one will tally up win number 43 on the year.
And on the season, this is going to be their third win in four games against this team.
The one player that really stands out, of course, in this one, it was a dazzling game.
You're so weird. You're up by.
And you have to love the effort he put forth on the glass. He played with the fire no one else could match as he chased down those rebounds.
There's Russell with the three. And they recover it. Vanderbilt kicks to James. Hits the three-point bomb.
I love when LeBron goes up with no hesitation, looking assertive off the catch.
7 second difference, shot and game clock. Moore against LeBron. Now here's Moore. He's guarded closer. Six to shoot. There's Noel, and Davis sends it back. And so it looks like the Timberwolves will retain possession here.
Substitution for your Timberwolves, Kyle Anderson, Jaden McDaniels, Anthony Edwards, Mike.
There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Offline with his three. And here's Davis for three. Misses the shot. And so it's the Timberwolves taking care of business here. It was a tale of two teams tonight. One that was in total control, operating flawlessly. The other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved.
Thank you, David, for working with me once again. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast.
Anything could happen. Anything could happen in the playoffs. So, now on to the Heat and the Hawks. Whatever team I find first, I got it. I got it. Devin Booker had the famous son. Caught a hop and I ain't have a Mario Chalmers. Ever since then, had a look at who I learned from. Won't respect, then you gotta earn some. Wanna strike, probably won't buy them. He wanna be like Nike, let me right after my sweet chin music. Then what about him? I'm at 87. Trey Young's at 80.
Well, here we go. We're like here. 3 versus 3. I made a slashing playmaker. I don't even know what Brian's build is. And George, why don't you talk about your build first?
I'm the yellow one on the end. I'm max height, max wingspan, tank beast, 6'10" with a 7'5" wingspan.
What all the right. Heck?
George, we're running with similar builds because Brianna Buckets over here is a 6'7" paint beast, max height.
Let's go.
Ready to go to work in the paint. So let's do it.
Okay.
Shots from earlier as the Miami team bus arrived at the arena.
What?
The players gearing up for a tough contest away from home.
Oh, I think that's only on
Hello,
FPM.
And Allie, take it.
Thank you very much, Brian.
Well, a lot to prove, Allie.
I think
Thank
I heard
you.
Of that, actually.
And
before.
This matchup, a little bit of a rarity now, Grant. Neither team in a hurry to get in
All
transition.
Right. Hopefully we can
Yeah,
win
these teams
one
have
game.
Almost a throwback style to how they play. They don't want to get up and down and play fast. They want to go slow.
That, like,
and that takes players who have patience
like
and discipline. Tonight will be a tactical battle. So a look at our starters for the Heat. On the wing, it'll be Hero and Butler.
Bam Adebayo is out there with Caleb Martin. And it's Lowry at the one. And for Atlanta, Young runs point with Murray at the two. Collins plays the four with Capella at the five. And it's Hunter in at the small forward position.
That's fast for just using LeBron James with that
slow. And here's Adebayo old head to the middle. Jump shot. And it's blocked.
Ooh,
right
snatch
out of the
block
air
by Capella.
Young against Lowry. Outside
Step
Young.
Back. Step back. And one.
And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws.
You know what, Trae Young?
He
just embraces being a villain to other teams' fan bases. Like he feeds off the fans heckling him on the road.
Well, Grant, as you said with Young, he's been the villain in the playoffs more than a few times.
Yeah, B.A., players who can embrace that are good for the NBA. Trae Young has fun being a thorn as a visiting player, and he always backs it up with his play.
Now here's Collins, a dependable player on offense, giving them over 13 a game. Murray for three, unable to get that one. And Miami will go the other way with it. Their last game, a win against the Magic, looking to carry it into this one.
And I think they were prepared to face pressure D. That never materialized, so they took advantage.
It took just a little bit of time, but once they figured out the D on that night, man, their offense was rolling.
And that was the mobile one drive. No resistance to the finish line.
You're toasting the defense and getting in close. They'll take possessions like that one all day.
Now here's Butler. Averaging almost 23 points a contest. A fantastic offensive player. With a nine-footer. Hero for three. He drops it from range.
And you would expect a quality play like that from a quality guard like Kyle Lowry.
They've been having major problems offensively.
Definitely in a bit of a dry spell.
Offensive rebound. That shot, no good.
I'm not going to see that very often. The defense in the vicinity, but still, he's not one to blow layups.
Hero. Then again, it's Miami converting.
Such a smooth shooter. Assertive hero right now on offense.
Got a piece of it. Oh, it's stolen by Butler. And out of bounds. Atlanta will have it. And you got to be in awe of incredible defensive efforts like this.
That'll put some fear into the shooters. And he made sure to do it early, too.
That was a good block.
Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far.
Oh, dude, that's a pass.
It's scooped up. Collins passes to Capella. Outside Young. Oh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take two free throws now. That'll belong to Kyle Lowry.
Young determined on that play there. The foul not keeping him from getting up the shot.
Vincent's checked in for Lowry.
After being drafted 19th overall in the 2017 draft, John Collins continuing to exceed expectations,
which
has contributed to what he does in terms of his workload.
What a two-way play. Just tremendous.
Yeah, the steal was slick. The slam topped it off.
And we say it time and time again, so I'll repeat it. Have to be careful with the ball, or this is what happens.
Collins has developed into much more than an athletic role man.
Oh,
yeah,
my
right,
God, bro.
The fact that he only attempted one three-pointer in college, and now is just letting it go here in the league. That is an efficient score from everywhere on the floor.
Well, the great ones make their mark in the playoffs, and Jimmy Butler has certainly done that. Some Herculean performances when the chips were down.
Kevin Love's checked in for Martin. Now here's Young. He's got seven. A quick shot there. It's off target.
Things are going south right now. This is not the type of shooting that his teammates expect from him.
Pass to Hunter. The kick out to Young. Beyond the arc.
I think I got a score.
A shot? No good.
It's been an ugly quarter for him. Trying to shoot his way out of it. Might be time to work on the playmaking skills.
Let's go.
Vincent can't hit.
What is he doing?
In last year's playoffs, Jimmy Butler became the first player since Jordan to author multiple 40-point, four-steal games in a single series.
Oh, and in 2020, the third player ever to record a 40-point triple-double in the finals. I mean, just legendary stuff.
Murray against Hero. launches it. Murray's shot is good.
These teams are finding the range, showing a lot of confidence.
It seems like they're going to find out who can make the deepest threes. Right now, it's a shootout.
Up the floor. And there's Collins on the assist from Young.
Pretty good body control from the big man as Collins stays focused on the rim.
The Heat have gone 5 of 9 from the floor. Pass to Vincent. Back to Butler. Now here's Hero. Inside. Here's Vincent. Collins against Love. Out of bounds. It'll be Miami's ball. And the Hawks making a change here. Griffin's checked in. Robinson, he's checked in for Miami. Victor Oladipo comes in for Hero.
That is so stupid. I got pushed out of bounds.
Butler against Collins. Stolen by Capella. Knocked loose. And here's the fast break.
They're like Daniel Jones.
Here's Butler. And the foul is called. He missed it. So he's got a couple of free throws coming as well.
He felt like he was getting more and more hungry as he got closer to the rim. Jimmy Butler just tenacious there. So much has been given by Jimmy Butler over the years. Hard to believe it took him a little while to make his mark early in his career.
The Heat making a switch here. Struce has checked in. Now here's Young. 7 points in the game. To the inside. Butler with a steal. And here we go. The Heat fast break.
Griffin.
The rebound by the Hawks. A chance to go 2-for-1.
And you really must play this just right.
To the wing on the left. Here's Murray. Can't get it to drop. And Miami will go the other way with it. Just 2 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. And it's Robinson penetrating. And you can count it.
Duncan Robinson is like 80 years old. How is he?
And Duncan Robinson with great focus to get the finish.
Free throw good, Robinson.
How is he making it?
The Hawks trailing. Outside Young. The three is up. And the three-pointer goes. Young's got 10 points in the game.
One of the more skilled offensive players that is on the floor here tonight. Not an easy fella to hold in check.
Up in time. No good on the buzzer beater. Good scoring in this one as we conclude the first quarter. It's 15.
The Heat, 19.
Hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far. Yeah. Halfway through the first half in this one. All right, guys, what do you think about the Heat here?
Just excellent first quarter defense. They've been really getting after it.
Just a great job, really, of making the game ugly, trying to muck it up a little bit out there.
On the court for Miami here in the second. David Martin out there with Bam Adebayo. Then there's Victor Oladipo. Then it's Max Strus. And it's Lowry in at the one. Adebayo. And the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
Bam grabs the board, and then Bam knows what to do.
How do I step back?
Lowry against Young. Griffin outside. 4-3. Miami grabs the miss. Their last encounter in Miami.
They really took a smart approach against this team the last time they faced off.
And let's swing it over to the sideline and hear from Allie.
Well, guys, Jimmy Butler's focus is all on team success. In fact, his agent said whenever he calls Jimmy to congratulate him on personal accolades, like overall NBA team, for example, Jimmy hangs up in his face before he can finish the sentence. Brian, for Butler, there's only one prize that really matters.
Yeah, he's a rare breed, Allie, for sure. Thanks for that. Going all in, that was the 2K drive. Well worth a second look.
Yeah, he's clearly not satisfied with the lead they have. Took it to the rack, it would not be denied.
Well, after getting off to a great start, hitting those first two shots, he's definitely regressed a little bit in this quarter.
Now here's Adebayo. Chalk up two there.
Oh,
Adebayo's gotten four this quarter.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. You know, that's why they continue to get attacked.
Offensive board. Here's Capella. The kick out to Griffin. There's the triple. Griffin's got himself going here. His first point of the game on the deep ball.
Pen pals, pay it. 10
of 10. The Heat with the lead.
And Graham, no team better than Miami. They should go check out that video.
Undrafted prospects.
I mean, for opening the Donruss Elite.
You look at last year's playoffs.
Dude.
Struce, Martin,
come
Vincent,
on. It's Kyle
Robinson.
Lowry. He's also 80
it's
years old.
It's allowed Miami to stay on top in a salary cap driven league. And Atlanta has possession after the basket
oh
by
my.
Miami.
Where's AJ Griffin at? He needs
Young
to get
against
the ball.
Oladipo. Pass to Griffin. Launches a three.
Bro, why isn't it the same right
gets
there?
Hauled
is
in by the Heat.
In the corner or something?
Adebayo's got five rebounds tonight. Let's it go from deep.
Why did I just scream?
Struce's shot is
like
off.
Like he can hear me.
Atlanta's gone just 1 of 5 so far this quarter from three.
One.
Oh, got Green that one
a point. AJ Griffin!
This story in the second quarter much different than the one in
catch
the first.
Shoot.
Finally seeing some aggression.
Lowry, the pass to Struce.
Oh yeah, that's called timeout.
Miami
decides
to
got
talk
over.
It over.
Let's go.
I mean, Trae Young.
Sharp shooting takeover.
Confidence. I mean, is
Now we're just over 2.5 minutes into the second. Struce against Griffin. Adebayo slams it in.
That's everything you want there. Bam Adebayo up there. Vertical, good hands, and a big throwdown.
And Young will challenge your defense from every distance, Brent.
Yeah, look, this guy, B.A., has unlimited range, has an elite floater game. And
hold up, I got to put my controller on the headset. I said put my controller on there. Okay, I had to put it on the charger in my bed. Sorry about that.
That's open. Now here's Hero. Give him
get
eight.
Out the paint, get out the paint.
Atlanta with a rebound. Capella's got 4 rebounds in the game. The Hawks have gotten only 2 of 8 field goals to go on the
oh
second.
My god.
To the paint. Kicks it to Hero. Takes a 3.
Right.
And Young pulls it down.
Given his range, you'd expect him to capitalize on that opening.
Here's Griffin. No good from the wing.
I swear.
For Miami, they've gone 5 of 10 in the second quarter. Pass to Lowry. Outside Struce. Elbow shot. Capella with a rebound. Capella's got his 5th rebound in this one. Griffin outside. Murray from outside. Adebayo grabs the board.
The Hawks are actually trash.
Rebound here tonight.
This feels
how
like
do they even make the play?
Bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
Griffin with it. Hero picks him up. From behind the arc. Atlanta
dude.
Again missing.
With
him struggling tonight,
that.
They need to find some other options out there to keep themselves in the game.
1:27 left in the first half of this one. Martin
oh
with the bucket.
God,
Martin's got his first bucket in this one.
They're really working the paint now.
And here's Griffin outside.
Drills it from deep.
He's going to punish you if you leave him open. He's more than willing to take the open three when he's got it.
Time called here. Miami decides to talk it over.
And one thing I've learned through the years is no matter the situation, there are always adjustments you can make.
So you're not just there to pump up or to discipline players. You've got to make sure that the coach makes the proper adjustments and has his team in the right mindset to carry it out.
And the Heat making a change here. Kevin Love's checked in for Martin. Jimmy Butler comes in for Struce. Robinson,
right,
he's checked in for Hero.
Get
and
that out
Vincent
of here.
Is subbed in for Lowry. They've got a chance
AJ
here
Griffin?
To cut the deficit to within 10.
Get back.
Butler against Griffin. Fires from deep.
Come on.
Another three for Atlanta.
Let it rain,
right
AJ Griffin.
That's tipped.
Oh.
Outside Robinson. Here's Vincent, guarded by Young. Fires the three. Kept alive. Right side Love. And the first shot of the night for him, no good.
He loved to make them pay for giving up that wide open jumper, just unable to do so.
Griffin gets it to go. 12 straight points off threes. His defense is not extending very well. Ooh, Griffin with the steal. Three-pointer. Hits the trifecta. And it's now just a one-point Miami lead. Exactly what every offense needs.
Shooters
who can
force the
defense to extend.
No, there's no doubt he's a legitimate threat in downtown.
No,
and
bro.
He's demonstrating.
Allie, as always, thank you. We'll be back right after the break for the third quarter.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports.
To skip through this.
It was a closely contested first quarter for Miami. They had a four-point advantage in the end of the period. They were outscored by
Griffin
just a bit.
10 more points.
And that wraps up the halftime.
Then Jimmy Bucket. Note that. Is he a better player? Probably not, because I'm on rookie mode and it's 2K. And yeah.
Halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been a fairly even one. Well, Brent, comparing eras, a touchy subject. But how do you juxtapose the era of your father, Rick, in the 60s and 70s, to your era, and even nowadays?
Well, I think between the rule changes,
Green,
the skill and growth and all the technology and science behind players, that it's really, really difficult to look back 25 years ago and compare the game. Just the game itself, PA, let alone talking about players and their skills.
Collins plays the four with Capella at the five. Young runs point with Murray at the two. And it's Griffin in at the three. So that's the Hawks
five. Step back. Oh!
And the Hawks with another three. Wow, five consecutive threes. This defense looking very frustrated right now. Boy, they'd love if anyone could get a bucket.
Yeah, their offense has been grinding to a halt.
Lowry against Young. Here's Martin.
Good defense.
No good. Young with the defensive effort. Boy, the offense has been on point.
They have great timing and great communication. So hard to get
AJ Griffin is going on.
After the first round,
AJ Griffin's going on.
The Hawks front brass admitted perhaps they've been too complacent.
Jimmy Butler can't shoot. Jimmy Butler can't shoot.
He can make a big impact.
Clint Capella makes a three.
Out of bounds.
What the?
Miami's ball.
But he looks like he got his ankle broken.
Let's catch up with Allie.
Well, Miami is very efficient. Coach Spoelstra said, quote, you want to maximize your offense in all the different ways in your menu without feeling like you're taking turns. I don't think anyone would say that about our team. They're an unselfish group.
Oh my gosh, stop calling timeouts. I'm going to try to turn the timeouts off, honestly. No, what? Options, settings. No.
Allie,
right.
Thank you.
I want to
take time called here. Miami decides to talk it over.
They're just giving away a run right now. The question is, can they stop the tie?
Hard to say right now. At this point, I see the coaches run through two or three iterations of defense.
Oh, my God.
Is there a fourth? I'm not sure. Yes, they won drops after the 0 of 3 start.
That's a weird shot.
Outstanding dribble drive. And that replay was brought to you by Mobile One.
Now, that's the kind of play that can really start a run. He knows a little momentum can get the
three.
Nails it from 3. Their strategy has been pretty simple here in the second half. Attack from 3-point range.
Maybe trying to find a little bit more space and ball movement to get guys open at the 3-point line.
Come on.
Butler on the wing. Pass to Lowry. Just 5 on the clock. Here's Martin. And he can't get that one. So Atlanta will take it the other way.
Trying to get it going. Only 1 for 5 to start the second half.
I'm going to set a pick and dunk on him.
Here's Griffin. They kick it out to Murray. Jacks up a 3. And the Hawks with another 3.
Defensively, they've been flat in this.
All right, I'm going to change it back. I don't even know why I did that. I'm sorry about that.
Second half, a very different type of team than we saw in the first.
You know, one-on-one.
Making a change. page here.
Gloves checked in. Gotta, I don't know how to put this. You gotta do something that's not allowed to win.
Here's Love. Well, he hasn't right. scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Lowry outside.
Wait, they got Kevin Love?
Pass to Martin. Puts it up from 12. Rebounded by the Hawks. Collins has got 11 rebounds in the game.
Step back.
Leg up on the boards and a big
for
leg
three.
Up the buries his 10th triple of the game. Unbelievable. Lowry, the pass to Hero.
Come on, come at me, boy.
To end the run.
Nope.
Collins with the rebound. Collins has got rebound number 12 here already in the game.
Come on.
You watch Tyler Hero night in, night out, and he brings a fearlessness to the game. Hero outside. Pass to Lowry. All alone.
Get that out of here.
Rebounded by the Hawks.
You can't ask for a cleaner look than that. He just couldn't deliver.
Some players walk the line between confidence and arrogance.
Well,
I think the interesting stuff BA
oh my
was,
god.
Stop
calling
holes.
I swear to God, if you go one more time I'm gonna
decides to talk it over. Trying anything now to get them out of this slump.
Well, they can't find the net right now, and all they need, I think, is just to get one to go, get back on track.
Trae Young, lock up.
Pass to Robinson.
Lock down, not lock up.
There's a minute 54 left in the third. They are really
close
struggling to stop this run.
Way.
Frustration seems to be mounting here, and you can see not just in their faces, but right now in their quick and hurry shot selection.
And just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
Oh, wait.
Here's Butler. Oh, and he got
that's the weirdest play
on.
Ever.
He'll head to the line to shoot two.
He gets halfway down the court from the ball rolling after I poked it away, and then he gets fouled.
In this league, unless you put in a lot of hard work, and there's some evidence that Jimmy Butler has done that through the years.
Trae Young.
And you look at the numbers Murray puts up, Grant. He's a threat to post a triple-double on any given night.
Come on.
And I love that about him, BA. I mean, he brings it in every aspect of the game. He doesn't hunt stats. The game just finds him. With his steal rate, might be the best bet to put up a quadruple.
Bro, he's the guy who ends the slump.
When he decides he wants to take it to the bucket, it's really hard for anyone to slow him down.
There's Young with the three. Oladipo with the rebound.
If you told me this was the kind of game he was going to have, I would not have expected them to be in front right now.
Butler on the wing.
Me personally, in real life, I do not have the Hawks winning.
Down to five on the shot clock.
That's me.
The Heat need to get one up in a hurry.
Like I said about the Lakers and the T-Wolves. Anything could happen in the playoffs.
On the inside and the defense not bothering that play.
Trae Young from Logan. Oh my god!
And it goes out of bounds. That one off Young. Oh. 40 seconds left in the third.
Come
here's
on.
Vincent.
We need the last shot. What is that goofy on jump shot, bro?
Vincent's got five.
Looks like a Dirk fadeaway, but from three.
Rotation, causing a breakdown along the perimeter.
Get that out of here.
A shot by Oladipo, no good.
AJ Griffin buzzer beater,
maybe?
They've
gone 8 of 13 in the second half. And here's Griffin outside, hits a three-pointer. Griffin's got 35 in the game.
He doesn't look satisfied with the lead right now. He wants more, and he looks like he's going to get it.
It's a clear look for Oladipo. Cans it with nobody near
I'm trying to get an AJ Griffin buzzer beater.
Sure-handed as a ball handler, Oladipo showing the moves there.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fires for three.
For three.
Oh. No good. Trying to get that one to fall. And so it's Atlanta closing out the quarter ahead.
End of the third quarter.
Looking to run whenever they can.
Probably
going to
win this game.
We'll be right back.
Probably going to win this game.
And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Talk about painting a magnificent picture with that dive. Just a great decision and a perfect delivery.
Yeah, those are the kind of plays that you want to put on a canvas. Just beautiful baskets.
No, I swear,
and one quarter to go in a game that, to this point, has not been an evenly fought contest. Setting the floor for the Heat, Lowry and Hero in the backcourt. Caleb Martin out there with Bam Adebayo. And it's Robinson into the small forward. Lowry, no good.
The D really getting away with one there. No one on him. And that's going to be good 9 out of 10 times.
Oh.
Griffin's shot is off. And for the Heat, they're shooting 40% so far in this one. Lowry with it. And it's Young picking him up. Takes the three. And Lowry is good for three.
Kyle Lowry
sensing the separation and then got that shot up pretty quick.
Right wing. Down low. Here's Capella. Over Adebayo. Capella can't get it to go. Miami has gone 1 of 2 from deep in this quarter. Lowry outside. Pass to Hero. Collins comes with a double. Inside. And that's out of bounds. Miami will keep it. Strus, he's checked in for Robinson.
Max Strus.
Good.
Fourth quarter, still Young. Just over a minute played. Lowry, good.
Kyle Lowry with a nice release on that one. It opens up the mid-range.
Take it to the basket.
Griffin, left side.
That's a green. No, it's not.
And once again, off the mark by Atlanta. To the middle. Lowry with the basket on the assist by Hero. Lowry's got 7 points here in the quarter.
Not sure which clips they watched at halftime, but he has figured out how to attack the D, and they kept him in check in the first half. He's flipped it.
Capella.
Hey, don't
and
it.
The lamp is
You're
good
literally
off the
wide open
glass.
You're like 6-10.
And the Hawks lead by 6.
And maybe they made some adjustments at the half. I mean, they're finally executing offensively.
Strus, the pass to Adebayo.
Sorry about my dog.
To the paint. Hero with the bucket.
They are passing the ball around tremendously right now.
Atlanta's gone 0-for-2 from John outside
Collins.
Here in the fourth quarter.
Thank you.
And when John Collins takes off from the floor, you can feel your hair
really
stand
like,
up.
One
really
of the most explosive
four,
players
actually.
In the league with this incredible liftoff. A strong step to the rim, and he can demolish anything in his path. Simply an electric player.
Probably from all those threes I was getting up.
And Brent, you look at Miami's playoff pedigree. They've made the Eastern Conference Finals 6 times over the last 12 years.
Yeah, and those 2 championships they had in that 12-year period were square on the shoulders of their big three that they
Get
put together.
Here.
But I don't see them slowing down. When it comes to reloading, this team knows how to do it.
That.
And they've just built this lead by attacking the boards.
And Griffin gets it to go.
And how aggressive has he been on the offensive end?
How many points
the team's points have been his.
The Heat have gotten 4 shots out of 6 attempts to drop so far in the fourth.
Lowry is washed.
Outside Butler. Lowry outside. Clock at 6. And he lobs it up to the rim.
Dude, this is unfair.
Really just mastery in the pick and roll from Kyle Lowry. Per usual, making the correct decision.
For 3, Collins.
John Collins, green, let it rain.
5 points now this quarter.
And their field goal percentage is finally creeping up after a tough first half.
Don't stop calling timeouts.
Time called here. Miami decides to talk it over. And this late game timeout, getting a breather here. Important for the players to recharge. This is where you have a chance to get rehydrated with some Gatorade. And now we present our new Balance Player of the Game, AJ Griffin.
This is special.
AJ Griffin with the Player of the Game.
Performance here tonight. He is like levels above everyone else on the floor. Something must have clicked for him in warm-ups tonight. He's just come out and he has run wild.
Well, he's getting in a groove at the perfect time, just as they're getting ready to do battle in the postseason. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with Allie LaForce.
Well, over the break, I listened in on Eric's
defense.
He is not happy about the perimeter play at either end.
They're not a ball can shoot. Dude, what the heck kind of defense is that?
They want to come out of here with the win.
And Allie, thanks. Love is checked in for Miami. The Hawks leading.
I feel like Clint Capella. Capella hasn't scored enough, so I'm going to try to get him some points.
Well, this kind of effort will energize the team and get you going, just gobbling up every
Dude, I'm really about to lose.
Tyler Hero in the zone. So it's Atlanta now.
Same one.
And he got the whistle on the way up, so he'll be headed to the line for a pair. And even from where we're sitting, you could clearly tell it was a
green.
All right, guys, what do you think so far on the offensive approach for the Hawks?
Their offensive game plan has been simple. Look to shoot it often from outside the arc.
Up by 6 points at that.
Have been outstanding.
Kind of my fault, because, like,
part of tonight's game has been the hustle.
I thought we were up by, like, 30 points. And then I just let them get a bunch of three-pointers, and then now they're
fantastic in that area.
Only down by 4 points.
Up and making a huge play for his team that time.
Up top, Capella. Rebound by the Heat.
Oh, what?
46 left in the game. Pass to Hero to the inside.
Now they're only down by two.
That's good.
Hero knows about the wins and the wears for an assist.
For Atlanta, they've gotten just 3 of 9 shots to go in. Struggling this fourth quarter. Murray passes to Capella.
No.
And stolen by Adebayo. Here's Lowry to tie it up.
No, he gets tied. I'm actually terrible.
Love's got 4 points in the quarter.
And Kevin Love, no stranger having the ball when it's tight like this. Terrific at stepping up.
Capella, pass to Collins.
Come on, let's go.
With a nice touch off the window. And the
Jump
Hawks
Collins,
lead by two.
And maybe not the first guy you think about. Collins in the clutch.
Let's go.
Let's go, still. Is Griffin.
AJ Griffin. He needs to shoot.
So he'll take two from the free throw line. So the first one drops. And that makes it a 3-point lead.
Let's go.
So he drops them both. And it's a 4-point ball game.
A productive trip to the line right there makes this a 2-possession game.
Miami has gone 2-4 from the perimeter here in the fourth quarter.
Uh-oh.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Trae Young.
Like, two timeouts.
That'll be a second foul of the game. Hero with it.
Come on.
Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get
he has tape over too.
Hero does so much damage off the bench for this team. Now here in the clutch, let's see if he can step to the line and come through.
And so Hero nails both of them.
And he's the one person that the coaching staff and the teammates love to see at the line in a tight ball game.
That's cool.
Pretty much banging
up.
Wow. That takes steady nerves right there.
Not backing down from this moment here. When the game is close, he kicks it up a notch.
Come on.
Murray against Hero.
All I need is it.
It's tipped.
Come on. AJ Griffin.
Pass to Young.
Young for three.
Yay! Another three. They've been battling all night.
Clutch Trey.
This game away.
No, great job of getting in position to win a game. It's been an all-out effort for the squad.
At this point, it just feels like it's over.
You want to keep expending energy, or do you want to start thinking about the next one?
We
time called here. The Heat decide to talk it over. They're trailing
by seven. Trae Young's turning around on that shot. Come on. No threes.
And so here is Miami. They trail by seven. Yes!
They down by five.
Not shy that time.
Butler can't get it to go.
Oh, my God. You're just so good.
The intentional foul.
Oh, my God. Capella can't shoot. Oh, my God.
And that hurts as he doesn't get the first one to fall. Trying to focus now for the second. And he does get the second one. And that increases the lead to six.
Coming under the wire. No threes.
Fantastic ball movement for them tonight.
If things are definitely working offensively, a balanced attack is just so much harder to defend.
And Hero getting to the spots where he can be very effective. That swagger he plays with is infectious.
It's never easy from that distance, but we see him drill those and shoot around all the time.
Oh, no, I know he can make it, but that's warm-ups, so maybe just a step too far.
Let's go. Let's go.
It's a narrow victory for the Hawks.
Let's go. We won.
Boy, they didn't make it easy on their fans or themselves.
Well, that's it for this video. Make sure to like and subscribe and comment down below who you think is going to win the NBA Finals. Peace.